this video is an old performance that I choreographed in 2015, but this isn't a reaction video this time around. It's more so for the people that need the entertainment while I talk. Welcome to vlog 19. I kind of wanted to make this one about like everyday management of like your own personal life, which is why I just woke up and I wanted to show you guys my morning routine and what I do every time I wake up. Sometimes I wake up and I get my bike and I go for a bike ride and then I do this, but for the most part I sit down in my chair and I go to my page. Now growing up I needed constant logging of my day, otherwise it didn't exist to me. It wasn't real. And I love the idea of so many techniques to manage, like journaling, making a big desk calendar and writing it in, or phone calendar on your phone that hits you with notifications. But none of them really stuck. None of them were really long term. Eventually I'd get a new phone. Eventually I'd run out of months on the big calendar. Eventually I'd either lose the journaling or I'd get too lazy to find a pen. But then I thought of the things that I do on a daily basis, and I always check my email, and that's something I knew that I always did. And then I fell in love with Google Docs. And before all of this, we thought we could rely on our brains, but our brains can only remember so much because our brains are constantly forgetting things, and that's necessary. Okay, I don't want you to think that it's bad to forget things. You wouldn't be mentally stable if you weren't capable of forgetting things. Watch that Black Mirror episode. You'll know what I mean. By the way, if you want to watch this video, it's somewhere on my YouTube channel. I'll link it below if I remember. Moving forward, I'm going to show you my method that I use to be organized. Let me just say that I am an extrovert. I used to be an introvert, but now I am an extrovert. So introverts internalize a lot of things, and they don't like a personal journal or something just to yourself might work better for you. But as an extrovert, we have all these social media platforms, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, TikTok now, all these things that where we create a profile for ourselves, and then we visit a feed or we visit a homepage as a base point, and then we go from there on our social media day, what we do to browse social media. I use Google Docs to create a homepage for myself so that I was capable of organizing my own life. Yee, my DoorDash, it's on its way. I do gotta say that this was a really fun dance that I made, and I'm so proud of it. This won best choreography that year at the Saddleback College Dance Showcase. This won best choreography, so I'm very proud of it. Like I said, I'll link it below if you really wanna check it out. On to what I do and what I use. Also, make sure you visit my website, jessichris.com, to check out all things me. Everything's here linked up in these buttons, and you can check out my schedule right here and contact me with the little prompt at the bottom. This is my homepage, okay? Don't worry, all the information that I put up there is false. Basically, I just have a constant reminder here to be happy, find happiness, to choose happiness is kind of the main thing, and that's what I put that. Ooh, I misspelled priorities. This is my homepage. And basically it starts off with that first line, be happy, to choose happiness. Because my motto to myself is, why? Why live life if you can't be happy? I know sadness is part of it, but why? Why not? Now this has basic information, my phone number, my email, my business email, my social security, my car make and model, license, and my license ID, and that's all there. I obviously know it and memorize majority of that, but it's there so that I know it's there. It's just kind of that self-assurance that it's there, and this is like my homepage to myself. I have a purchase wish list over here. These ones I just logged in, glasses, car mechanic, yeah, stuff like that, for needs and wants, because you're always going to want to change. This is always going to switch up depending on where your life's going. And your needs and wants, your purchase wish list, keep it there. And then that way, also, if somebody asks you, what do you want for your birthday? You could just look at this, your wants or your needs, honestly. So then current life categories, this is basically your priorities. What you want to prioritize the most. On the top of mine, I have me. I put me as a priority at the top of mine. And then you list it down for the things that are important to you. What made work, your dog, your family. This all changes for everybody individually, and I don't need a physical representation of what I prioritize, but it's nice to look at it, something to make you think. Doesn't mean it's right, like your list from top to bottom. You can even have this numbered. I don't have it numbered because they're all kind of my priority. Like, if I had it numbered, I'm not going to choose one over the other. But that's how I do that. And if you've ever worked with me in the past, you know that I make sheets like this. When I'm brainstorming ideas, I make a Google Doc with somebody and I share it. And then I set it up just like this where I create a table. And then we start brainstorming and putting things in the categories. Same concept, but I just do it for my life also. Then I have debts over here. You know, what And then I have debts over here, what depends on you, if you have debt. If you don't have any debts, you can change this category to investments, and then you can list out what you're investing in. But I'm not at that stage yet, and I'm at debts, and I have like student loan debt, credit card debt, if you have mortgage, kids' tuition, things like that. Your debts are right here, things you have to pay on a monthly basis and get rid of, phone bills. You can put that all there, whatever you have debt-wise, all the money you owe. Then I have the links. This could be anything and everything. A link that you found super inspirational, you put it here. It's just an important link or another document to something. I have documents here of like my finances, my tax information, my business numbers, all things for that specific purpose are right there. All the links that I have shared with other people, like when I'm working with somebody else, I would put their link here so that I can access it right away. And then right when I open up Google Chrome, this is my homepage. It's my homepage for me. I get to type what I want. Then you go down here and you scroll down. This is just the template for it, you know, where it's the date, day of the week, mood, details, notes, agenda notes. And then basically, I have this down for 2 years now. Nothing ever stuck. I tried journaling. I tried all these different things to keep me like disciplined in my everyday actions. And nothing's worked except for this. And then you do the template here, which you fill in. So if I was having a normal day, right? I mean, like if I started, like I just woke up, like, right? Like we'll do today. Okay. We will do today. I know it's going to be a while for this video to release, but the actual day that it is August 13th, 2000, not 19. I didn't make this up. Far we go. But yeah, August 13th, 2020. And then I type day of the week. Why this is here, day of the week, it is a Thursday. It's because this is where I usually remember, oh crap, I have to do that today. Oh crap, I have to do that because I said, oh yeah, I'll do that Thursday early on in the week. And it keeps me accountable for that. So I type in Thursday mood, like literally this, what you're feeling in that. I feel inspired, I feel motivated to move. You can fill this out however you want. Then you type in the goals, just the basic things you need to do. Feed the guinea pigs, don't even worry about like mistakes unless you're that type of person, like typing spelling errors, things like that. Feed guinea pigs, change cage out, run errands, do groceries, do laundry, do, you know, whatever you need to write out for your goals to get done today. You write it all out there, then you can like take a look at it and it's filled. This bullet point up here is at the end of the day. If you choose to come back, that's why a majority of these from before are blank, is because that's if I go back to that day, but usually I don't. But if I feel like capitalizing and saying more things about my day, this bullet, the top one without the star, is where I write like you had a lot accomplished today, and you like list them out and you feel good about it. This star here though is where I just write. This is the journal entry right here, is where I just write whatever I want. Where I write whatever I want to myself, like, hey man, keep pushing, keep grinding. You don't have to do this every day. It's okay if you miss a day. You just copy and paste the temp and you keep moving forward no matter what day it is. There are like week-long gaps on mine, but I stay consistent in terms of I will always go back to this when I'm finding that open moment, that open morning. And this is how I keep myself organized, and this is how I am able to basically function day to day and be consistent with my plans and ideas. I hope that helps you. I hope you find your method, but this is the method I found after trial and error for years. I've been, you know, I've tried Tumblr, I've tried different blogging things, but this works for me because it's internal. And then you be completely honest with yourself in this star over here. This little box right here is your box for you, and it's my box for me. I write that, like, this person says something offensive to me. I write the most horrible stuff there. And I make it real because your emotions are real and what you feel is real. So you write what you need to write there. You're not going to send this to anybody. This homepage is your homepage. This homepage is personal and it's for you. If you don't trust the internet and Google Docs, then you do this on a Word document. Just know that you know that you're being real with yourself somewhere. And this is where it is for me. Now, my DoorDasher is approaching and I'm very hungry. But thank you for watching this video. I hope it helped you in some way. Like only if you mean it. Subscribe only if you mean it. New YouTube videos every Tuesday, 9:15 p.m. I stream on Twitch. My schedule is right there at jessichris.com. Visit jessichris.com for everything. I try to keep that updated as much as possible. Thank you for listening to me. You have a wonderful night or day. Also podcasts. I do that too. Okay. Bye.